All right, it is time for my annual pie book tag. So if you don't know, today is Pie Day. Pie Day is a very dorky day, but I love it. It's March 14th in the United States. It's March 14th everywhere, but I know that other countries don't like do month and date, but if you do month and date, it's 3.14, the first three digits of pi. I am a nerd. That's fine. Last year I did a Pi Day book tag, and I can link that in the cards. Maybe, I don't think I repeat myself in my answers, and I've also revamped it slightly, and hopefully I have some friends who I've given the tag to again, and I talked about it on Twitter, so anyone who wanted to participate on the day could. Today is a very important day, where you pretend you care about math, but really, you eat pie. And so I have a bunch of prompts I put together to talk about the dorkiness of the number and talk about books, because that's who I am. So let's get into it. Number one, pi is an irrational number. Name a character that you find irrational. I don't know if this really counts, but I find a lot of what this character does to be extremely irrational, and that is Kyle from the live ship Traders. I do not like Kyle. He frustrates me a lot, and one of the ways he frustrates me, one of many of the ways he frustrates me, see my spoiler vlog for Ship of Magic if you really want to know, is that his decisions make no sense to me. They're completely irrational. I'm just like, sir, your logic makes no sense. If this is your goal, if you're honestly talking about your goal here, this is not how you get to your goal. This is how you screw up your goal. So if you're gonna be mean and hurtful, at least be smart. At least don't be irrational and making bad decisions. So that is who this year wins the Most Irrational Character Award. Number two, pi comes from the word perimitro, which means perimeter. Talk about a book that has to do with borders between countries or worlds. So I am going to do two. One, because I can't ever stop talking about it, and that's Machineries of Empire by Yoon-ha Lee. This literally is a military space opera. We're in space, and literally it's about fighting on the borders between different galactic empires. Like, that's the premise, is that the Hexarchate wants to expand or not lose land. So it cares a lot about its borders. The actual sci-fi elements care a lot about the borders of what are called calendrical systems. It's also a very math-based sci-fi system, and this is a math book tag, so it seems like it works. Another one I'm going to mention, because I haven't talked about it for a while, and that is Midnight Robber by Nalo Hopkinson. This kind of has parallel worlds, and I think it's a really interesting story. You have Tan Tan and her father, who start in a more high-tech planet, end up through circumstances in this lower-tech parallel planet, and it's about how she has to survive and deal with the situations. A lot of heavy, heavy trigger warnings for this one. I do have a spoiler-free review if you want to check it out. I really think it's a fun, imaginative sci-fi. It reminds me a lot of some of the visuals I got from the Avatar Blue People movie. I always have to say that because sometimes people think I'm talking about the Avatar Last Airbender movie, and like, when is anyone talking about that in a positive way? Like, I haven't even seen it because my friends tell me it's too painful to watch. But those are two I'll bring up because I really liked Midnight Robber. I will say, like I say in my review, it is written in a dialect, so if you can get your hands on the audiobook, that's probably a little bit better. But like, I really, really liked reading and discussing that story with my friends. Number three, the value of pi seems to be built into the Great Pyramid of Giza. What is an Egyptian-inspired book that you recommend or want to read? Well, I don't think this is shocking, but I want everyone to read the Dreamblood duology by N.K. Jemisin because I love N.K. Jemisin and I love this book specifically, which is the second book. The first book is good, but the second book is like, it's amazing. And it's purple, which is a really nice color. But this is a heavily Egyptian-inspired fantasy world. So it's not in Egypt, but it's heavily inspired by Egypt. The actual city, I can't remember, Gujarat, is really inspired by one of the major trade ports in Egypt, down to how she represents the cultures in that area and the differences and just the multicultural aspects of it, because that's how it would have been like in ancient Greece. The magic system is based off the four humors, which is a thing from that era of the world. Is really good. Obviously, there are other ones, like I have been enjoying P.J.L.E. Clark's Cairo series in Egypt, and there's also the Davabad trilogy. But real talk, read the Dreamblood duology. It's really good. Number four, pi is a constant. What's a comforting book constant in your life? So I think last year I talked about Elantris and rereading that book and how it's just always nice to have it there. And this year I'm going to be more broad because I've been rereading more and that's been like amazing for me and rereading in general. And also the idea that there is always going to be that vacation read. If that makes sense, like there are reads books that I read like all the time, but then there are those books that I don't necessarily save for vacation, but like I find myself gravitating towards them, those like fast paced, can't put them down, all consuming reads. When I have all the time in the world to stay up till 3 a.m. to finish them, like looking forward to those moments and then returning to the rereading moments in life, those are such amazing book constants. They've always been there for me. And I'm really happy that they're there because it's really how I get through my year is sometimes looking forward to those moments where I'm stuck in an airport with a book or something like that. Number five, pi has infinite decimal places. What is a series you feel will never end? I don't even know if this was my answer last year. There's a high chance that it was my answer last year, and that is the Wheel of Time. So when I did the tag last year, I'd only read 2 of the books. And since then, I have now read 5 total. There are still 9 full-length novels and a novella left. Like, I have read in the course of the past year, like 3,000 pages in that series. And I feel like I'm not even near the meat of it. It's very interesting. I have found that listening to the audiobooks is probably primarily how I'm consuming them. So I think this time last year, if I did use Wheel of Time, I was still physically reading. And I just like, it takes me so long to read a Wheel of Time book. Not only is it a high page count, but it's a really hard writing style for my brain to consume quickly. I get very distracted while I read it. It's hard for me to focus. And then when I am focusing, I have to like reread the passage because I'm trying to figure out, was this a descriptive thing that doesn't matter, or was this a descriptive thing that matters? And I really need to try really hard to make sure my brain is like trying its best here because I don't visually see things very well. And so that series for sure feels like that it will never end, that I'm actively reading. And I, you know, like obviously there are other series that haven't ended and won't for a long time, like the Stormlight Archive, but like I'm not excited for it to end. I feel like my heart's gonna be ripped out when it ends, so I'm cool with that like being my staple for the next forever. I wonder if that's what I had for book constant last year. The previous year's tags in the cards, it's Baby Angela, but boy did she really want to make a Pi Day book tag. Number 6. Some people feel that it would make more sense to use the number tau, pi times 2, instead of pi in math. What is a character you think should have gotten more page time in a book? So like what I mean by that is like mathematicians are dorks, like extra dorks compared to me. And they're like, we shouldn't be using pi, we should be using tau because that makes more sense. And so, yeah, that's just, you know, random math fact. And so this one, I think I am going to go with the rook from Mask of Mirrors. The rook is very interesting. The series is called The Rook and the Rose. And the rook, whenever he's on page, it's like the best scene. And he's on page like a fair bit, but I could have used more. Like, yeah, I could have used more. I really hope he's more involved in the sequel, which comes out in November, guys. Ah, I'm so excited. I have this. I can reread from it. I have a review for this if you're curious. Like, it's a very pretty cover. I think it's an extremely fun, kind of cozy long fantasy read. Like, it is a long book, like, obviously, lots of pages. But I don't know, I find it to be that type of fantasy where like I don't mind that the pacing's slow because I'm with people I really care about and I'm really invested, and it doesn't feel like it takes a long time, but it objectively is like a long experience. So when you're feeling that, which I feel frequently, that's like kind of my mood, like 80% of the time, is great. Number 7, what's your favorite pie, and name a book that you feel embodies that pie? I am cheating. I'm not going to talk about my favorite pie this year. I did last year. This year, I'm just going to talk about Biddy from Check Please. And Biddy loves to make pie. So I just needed Biddy to be in this tag somewhere. This is such a cute webcomic. Highly recommend for all the wholesome feels. Biddy makes pies for his fraternity house. I don't even know if it's a fraternity house. It's more like he plays hockey and he lives with a bunch of other hockey players. So it's kind of like a frat house. And he cleans their kitchen and makes them pie. And they all love Biddy. And is so wholesome and great. And I guess if you really needed to know my favorite pie, I think last year I said sweet potato. I do really like a good sweet potato pie. I also like cheesecake, which I know is technically not a pie, but like it has a crust and it's very similar. Also, apple pie is really good. I like a good rhubarb, but not strawberry rhubarb. Like, that's fine. Like, I'll eat it. I'll eat almost any pie. You put free food in front of me, I will probably consume it, like, barring weird texture problems. And yeah, I like pie. So that is the Pie Day book tag. It's a pretty chill one. I have a bunch of friends who are doing them today, so I'm going to collect them in a playlist, and I'll have that playlist linked down in the description below. If you want to do it, I don't care if you post it after Pie Day. Feel free. I will still come watch it because I love pie in all of its forms. And also, I guess, if you're feeling real clever and you want to do this Pie Day tag later, pie is technically like 22 divided by 7. And this was brought up actually by Nikki, who's a fellow space siren. So you could, on July 22nd, post the Pie Day book tag and make that your Pie Day. I don't really care if there's two Pie Days in a year. I don't think it needs to be that strict. And obviously the emoji is leaving a dessert or a pie slice. I'm basic, I'm not going to reinvent the wheel here. And if you want to just answer the prompts yourself, you can do that in the comments. You can go to my Discord. Any of those options are wonderful with me. And like if you liked it, subscribe if you want to, and I will see you in the next one. Bye!